Oh, he done got the bezel bizzle on me. God damn, boy. Nah, though, man. I'm here with my boy Xavier Simpson, man.
Yo, it's your boy Coke King, and you looking at your young, hottest, funnest young nigga right here, man. Today, hold on. You know we back with a banger, man. I ain't gonna tell it too much, man. You feel me? I'm in the whip right now on the highway. You feel me? Just, you know, about to pull up on a hometown favorite, man. One of the hometown guys, you feel me? Xavier Simpson, you know, Mr. Michigan, whatever the fuck you want to call my mans, you know. It's X, though. Wow. You know, don't know him as X Simp, you feel me? Baller, big baller, you know, the whole nine. But y'all know what y'all gotta do today, man. Like, comment, subscribe, Coking Entertainment. Before we get any further into the bid, you know what to do, man. I'm not gonna tell y'all again. I'm not gonna keep telling y'all. Y'all know what to do, man. God damn, it's hot as fucking with the bitch. God. I'm about to turn on the air after this bid. It's cool. Whoa, shit! Hold on, bro. I'm about to go buy a motherfucking white tee, cause this finna sweat this gray one for real, bro. I'm hot, though. But y'all know what to do, man. Like, comment, subscribe. Man, I'm about to hit this air on, man. Y'all know what to do, man. Like, comment, subscribe, Cocaine Entertainment. I'ma make another bid, man, when I pull up, man. It's too hot, though, man. I'ma holler. Hometown made slime, man. Talk to him, bro.
Man, just chilling, man. Getting the creative game about to move out.
Damn.
How you doing? What's up, too?
Shit, you feel me? I just had to pull up on you, check your tent, dog. I don't got. Where I did yet? Dog, they did me foul. I'm thinking it was gonna be the tea. He done took all this shit out my time. Dog, done came, but it's cool, though. You feel me? I'm gonna forever pull up on my nigga X-Cent. But hey, though. I ain't gonna lie to y'all though. Before anything, no cap, boy, y'all know what to do, man. Hit that subscribe button, man. We ain't gonna play. Hit that like, comment. I ain't gonna tell y'all too much, man. You know how it's cold slap, man. We gonna keep y'all posted. Give you about five. Slap! Goddamn, boy, what's taking you goddamn forever? slide above that goddamn room, y'all. Ooh, he done got the bezel bizzle on me. Goddamn, boy. Nah, though, man. I'm here with my boy Xavier Simpson, man. Mr. Michigan right here, whatever. Like I said, whatever you want to call him, man. But I got a few questions for you. Oh, you were top 100 when you do this.
Wow.
That was in high school.
Ooh, he been doing this. Yeah. Nah, let me ask you a couple questions, though, man. So,
where you be heading at, though? I see you got some bags packed. First off, you feel me? I feel the house looking clear. Where you finna head to, buddy?
Man, about to move out. Pretty much move out. Shoot to the crib, see the family. And start my pre-draft stuff. Yeah, that's about it, man. That's why the bags packed, everything about the shit. Last day in the crib, man.
That nigga got TVs in this motherfucker. Goddamn, you got two doubles on you, got man.
But nah, no, let me talk. We gonna pause that. Nah. My second question, though, I got for you, though, Mr. Xavier Simpson. How did you feel about your accomplishment at Michigan as as a all-time assist leader?
Man, it feel good. Definitely feel good. It's something I never dreamed of, but I mean, it's something that hard work pay off, man. You gotta go, just try to achieve and do the most you can, and just whatever time you got. It feel good though, man. To have my name up there, one of the greats, feel honored for sure.
Damn, this boy giving out more assists than I don't know what.
I'm lying. Man, I'm trying to do a little something here.
Let me go to question three, man. I ain't gonna, you feel me? Let me get you a little pop, man. So, what do that motherfucking tattoo represent right there?
This one?
Yeah, man. I see you a little tatted, man. Oh, damn, yeah, son. Damn.
Yeah, shout out to my man K-Rod.
For sure. This is basketball with some Nets. I wanted to get a tattoo on my leg. I thought it was unique. And obviously, on a human body, your legs make you go. And basketball took me many places. You know, this is a basketball and it's a globe. So it's a basketball and it's a globe to show the basketball took me many places with an airplane behind it, showing how I'm traveling. Because basketball, I'm not sure if I'll be the person I'm today.
Then I got the King, because you know me, I always got to feel like a boss.
Ooh, he big, man. He big step.
Then I got the leg. Then I got the eye, and you see in the eye, say DC.
Okay.
Dream Chaser. It look a little better with some lotion. I'm ashy, but Dream Chaser to show my eyes.
Hey, you want to have some lotion? No, let me phrase that, man. You feel me, man? You have to... You know, show off the hard ass, you feel me? Cause I ain't know, I did ass ain't know what it mean, for real. I knew it was like basketball, but I just wanted to know, like,
sure,
why you got it on you, cause some people ask that, you feel me?
Body gotta have some meaning behind it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Okay, so you explained that very well, so. Damn, though. No, I don't know, man. It's like, you got it, shit. It's like, you feel me, man? The drive coming up and shit, man. You know, I'm gonna let you do the work on that. You know, I'm gonna let you just do your thing, you feel me? When the drive comes, sure, you feel me? It's gonna just gonna elevate. But this was another question I was meaning to ask you, though.
Go ahead.
Man.
No, I'm all for my babies.
So you was just out in LA, right? You know, with Travis Walton. Can you please explain a little bit about Travis Walton, who he is to you, and how he impacted your career as a hooper, basically?
Okay, yeah, Travis Walton was a cat. I was born with when I was senior. I was young. I think I may have been like third or fourth grade, maybe second or third grade, maybe first. I was young, he always played a lot of senior. He was kind of like the role model. He was a guy that was coming in, dropping the numbers, that was working in the gym, that went to a big time university, Michigan State University. So it was just good having somebody like that. Then when I went to Michigan State, he showed me around, he had it. Like, you can tell people respected him for what he does. And that just always motivated me to go my different direction, do the same thing. And I just happened to be blessed by God to have opportunities to do this at the University of Michigan. But being on account of him, he's helped me a lot. Just keeping my mind open, being able to do different things and just ways of being successful without basketball. So definitely appreciate the big brother Travis Walton, man. But he definitely was that role model that I always looked up to, that I was kind of chasing. And to see them both in LA from Lyme, Ohio, that shit touched him. So.
Hey, Trav, man, I'm going to say it for you myself, man. Shout out to you, man. You did a lot for the city, man. Hey, for real. Hey, for real. But now I had to sneak that in there, Trash. Shout out to you, though. You know, 419 forever, man. You know what we represent, man. But sure. Anyways, though, back to you, though, man. We can't get off you too much, man. You know, what brought you to Michigan? Like, what gave you that desire, you know, coming out of high school with all these recruits coming at you, know, all these colleges, you know, from AAU all the way through your senior year in high school? Like, what made you just be like, okay, Michigan is my best fit for me?
I thought Michigan was the best fit. Because I watched Trey Burke's play style, Derrick Rose's play style, with two great point guards who played before me. And it was beneficial off the court as well. Obviously, Michigan is a huge, huge business school, and a lot of people be successful pretty much here. So I just wanted to use it for the networking, being able to have a chance to push myself outside of basketball school, or being able to get a degree from here and graduate. So that's why I made my decision somewhere that's going to benefit me on the court and also benefit me off the court. Then when I came here, I felt like it was a sign from God, showing that this is the school I was supposed to attend.
Cause we ain't gonna lie, that nigga would drop buckets on your
ass. Ain't gonna cap.
Hey, though, we gonna shut that boy out, man, real quick, for real, no cap. Hey, Miss Lady, you wanna say something to him one time?
Say what's good,
Daisy. Yeah, you know, I can't leave you out, you feel me?
Oh. Hey, everybody. How y'all doing?
Okay. This Miss Michigan, you feel me? I call her Miss Michigan, you feel
Miss
me?
Michigan.
Yeah, you feel me? Big time, you feel
Shout
me?
Shout out to DePaul, though.
She transferred from Michigan, she loved DePaul.
Yeah.
We still fuck with DePaul, you feel me? You got social media, though? You want to shout them boys out on?
Yeah, it's Deja Church XL.
Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat.
No Snapchat. It's Instagram and Twitter.
Hey, y'all heard it, man. Y'all know what to do, man. Y'all got to shout her out and go follow all her social media accounts. Anyways, we back on you, though, man. Like, I know I got a little bit sidetracked, you know, accent, you know, with that. But, hey, though, get too comfortable with me, though, accent. Now, hey, though, man. So, this is going to be, like, my last question, but it's going to be, like, I feel like it's going to lead it all, man.
So,
what is you going to do with your success as, you know, like, just as how far as you came, like, How is you going to use that energy into basically giving back to your family, like your dad and your mom and them? Like, you get what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Basically, I'm just going to grind it out now, continue to grind, so hopefully one day I can get a good, nice little check and be able to just pretty much help them financially. Having a chance to be there for them, interact with them. I want to be the type of guy to go with my family, have a chance to interact with them mentally, stay connected spiritually with them.
and just be there. But right now, I got to just grind. So at the end of the day, everybody want a bag. I feel like this is my gift. So just grind, get a bag. And money, where I'm from, money can solve a lot of problems. So that's definitely my objective. Handle my business.
As y'all hear my man, he ain't gonna say it too much longer. He ain't gonna say it too much. Coach Q, man, I'm gonna say one thing, man. I'm gonna shout you out one time, man. Got your son right here, man. You heard what he just said for you. He most definitely gonna look out for you. But anyways, though, we would like to conclude with a little quick question and answer set that we just had. Make sure y'all follow Xavier Simpson and yeah, y'all can't forget it, man. Y'all know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe, Cocaine Entertainment. Slap!